it was time to go home. I would leave Istanbul the next day. The group I was traveling with had scattered. Some were already home. The last few of us would fly out the next day. That next day, a volcano blew in Iceland, and nobody flew anywhere for a few days. For several days, I played cards with strangers in the hotel lobby while trying to get a flight home. An older couple, he a retired pastor, was also hanging around, and the stress was wreaking havoc with his heart. After a few days, we were offered a flight to Tel Aviv, and we could fly to New York from there after another day or two. All three of us accepted that offer, and I reminded him of the world-class medical care available in Tel Aviv. I had decided to return to Bethlehem while I had the chance and made arrangements to stay at Yevan's Inn. I thought we had a plan. This couple decided that they too would come to Bethlehem with me. He said there were worse places for an old preacher to die than Bethlehem. His wife agreed. Against my better judgment, we three traveled to Bethlehem. Yevan took one look at us, brewed the Rev some herbal tea, and calmed his fears. His color and blood pressure improved. Eventually, we had a chance to visit the Church of the Nativity to see the traditional birthplace of Jesus. We had lunch in Manger Square and spent another night at the inn. Bethlehem had become a home away from home for me. A safe place to bring weary travelers, an inn that did have room for us, and a place for a fellow to catch his breath and recover. We all made it home safely.
O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide.